Good morning, and it's obvious what we are trying to do here, right? So, Jeremey, you have my copy of my book. You haven't passed me yet.
Hi, everyone. Yeah, Aldric, yeah, your book is still with me. So, I just want to do a call out to Timothy DeJesus, who has recently become our in-house bottoms-up perspective in-house author. So, he has written this book, The Business of Time. And I just want to do this call out video with Aldric, just to, you know, support him a little bit. And support him I did, you know, day one when it was launched on Amazon. I quickly, took the link and bought two copies, one for Aldric, one for myself. I had the option of opting for a signed copy, which I told Tim I was not going to do the signed copy because I eventually want to bring this book to him and I have him sign the copy face-to-face, you know, in physical form. So I'm looking forward to that.
And we should record it on video.
Exactly. I want to do that, you know. I'm done with this virtual thing, you know. We should do something physical for one. So I look forward to that. But before that, yeah, I've been doing a bit of reading. And I think I could just really give some advice to those who are wondering what this book is about. You know, just go get it, you know. Because for most of us, I think we go through life not understanding the value of time versus money, versus what you are doing for money or what you rather do with time while your money is working hard for you. Okay, this book addresses that. I mean, I wish I knew Timothy 20 years before and I read this book 20 years before. It would have saved me literally time and money. And lots of heartache, and are probably, you know, much richer in time, money, and life than I probably am right now. But better late than never. For those who are younger than me, you know, this is your chance to get ahead in life, and generally, you know, make more good choices, make more out of your time, make more out of your money, and generally, be happier in life, which is what we're all trying to do.
Yeah. The way you say things is just so interesting. I wish that I met Warren Buffett 50 years ago. I wish that I met Napoleon Hill maybe 100 years ago, right? Oh, come on. That's not the right way to think about things.
That's why a time machine is important. Yeah, but this is the next closest thing to a time machine, you know, for all those out there. Yeah, so that's my take on this book, you know. Go
definitely.
Get it.
Definitely. And before you pass it to me, maybe if I were to ask you on how I can get started on a book, I actually start reading on the book, and that is what are kind of your quick executive takeaway that you can share with me now, maybe just in point form, but things that really hit you, like it punched you and it pulled the strings in your heart.
Okay, put it this way. I can't say I don't know the things inside here, but the point is these are things and lessons I've learned and accumulated through my life and, you know, with a bit of thinking. But the point is you know, rarely has those trail of thoughts been presented in a very structured, methodical, and a logical way with computations and calculations and examples and complete checklists for you to do your own self-check. So I think this is really more, other than being a theoretical, conceptual book, it also has very, very simple and valuable tactical mechanisms in it, right? Checklist for you to improve yourself on. So really, it's quite a neat package. It's easy read as well. So that's my executive take on it. Yeah.
I see. So I think in Tim's book, he did mention like what are the kind of expenses that you need to cover if your household size is of this headcount and things like that. So I think where it applies to you, and I'm going to ask you too. So you are in a household of four, right? Two kids.
Correct.
Your wife, two kids, and you don't have any elderly dependents, I think, in your household.
No, so, I do actually.
Okay. So what's the household count for you?
Two on my side and two on my wife's side. Yeah. So sorry, what's the question again?
So your household count is eight. Am I right to say that?
Two, four, yeah, including me. Yeah, you can say that, yeah.
So, right. So based on Tim's book, what is that magic number for a household count of eight?
He only calculated, I think, for three and three kids. Three kids.
Oh,
household,
man.
Right?
Okay, so, okay. So yeah. Let's say a household count of four with
but you
two
see,
kids. What was the...
No, but you see, it's just an example for you to do another calculation, right? But the key tools you need, the key consideration aspects you need to do that calculation, customized to yourself, you know, that one you can really find this book. And I think that's where the value lies in. That's a good question. I have not actually really counted like for my own household, right, of 8, because I only consider it as 4. But in any case, you know, I'll take some time and do my calculation later.
Oh, come on. That sounds so patronizing. But anyway, so Tim's structure in his book talks about the number of kids, right? So with you, it's 2 kids. So what is his idea on like the business of time if you have 2 kids? Like, briefly speaking, what did he actually propose?
Although actually on the part with the household expenses, it's really more of give you an example on what your expenses could be. And if you know that and you know what your inflow in terms of income, then you know how much you can save, technically and theoretically speaking. So in a way, it's trying to establish how much you make versus how much you spend, which will equate to what you can save. And then with that amount of savings, you know, what you can plan to do to make your life easier over the years. Accumulation of wealth, having your money work harder for you, and at the same time, and because of that, you can save time, so you have more time to do what you like, to spend more time with the family, and basically, you know, understand the value of time and where you can apply it that is best suited for yourself. So, which is just why the book is aptly termed, you know, Business of Time, because everything can be measured in time and money, and that's where he tries to go into details on why you should value both and value them differently, and really identify the relationship between the two of them versus what you want to do, what you love to do, what you're passionate about, and you know, set your direction in life in the right path, lah. Because you know, most of us would know that we would rather do things, not do things we like, but stick on with what we are doing now for money, right? So then that's the question, right? Are you just looking for money, or are you doing something you enjoy but maybe on a lesser pay? You know, but all this really also depending on, you know, you still have to pay the bills, you still have to pay your taxes, you still have to feed your family. So it's really this whole entire relationship easily decked out in you with checklists to help you plan. It's not going to help you. So to me, I think that's where it's going to be useful for a lot of us who probably just step into the world, work life, right, in this entire pandemic situation. And if you get this right, I think in the coming years, it will help you, I believe, immensely. It will benefit a lot.
Yeah, oh, that sounds like a very strong endorsement for our buddy's book, isn't it?
Of course, yeah.
Okay, one final shout out, and then what are you going to say?
Yeah, so go on and get this book. I think I've said enough.
Amazon, right? It's Amazon, and I think for Singapore, it's just that option.
Correct. We'll leave the link, and yeah, you definitely can order it through Singapore. However, I've got my copy, and it reads quite fast. Yeah, you have to pay for delivery, but you know, if you are an Amazon a member, then yeah, I think delivery is free. But in any case, yeah, it's going to be more valuable than the cost of the book and plus the delivery. So I think we'll leave the link for order in the description below, and go grab a copy now.
All right, then.